Good morning again. Proverbs 22:6 says, "Train up a child in the way he should go. Even when he is old, he will not depart from it." Hi, Pastor Woody. Seems so simple, doesn't it? And probably one of the most quoted or maybe misquoted verses in the Bible. People often, you know, they use this verse as a guarantee that if you raise your children, like it says in Ephesians, in the discipline and the instruction of the Lord, they'll always stay on the right path. That doesn't always seem to happen, does it? You know, even good parents often see their older children stray from the faith. We do our best, and sometimes the results are different than what we would have hoped for. God has given us all free will to make our own choices. So rather than a promise, it could be a warning. The key word being should. Train up a child in the way he should go, giving us the understanding that you shouldn't allow your children to go their own way, but train them, teach them. Children left on their own, they're likely to become adults who go their own way, the wrong way. Interestingly, you know, Solomon wrote later in Proverbs that folly is bound up in the heart of a child. He obviously recognized that children don't tend to make the wisest choices on their own. And yet, there's another view. I'm not a theologian or Bible scholar, but I am a parent, a grandparent, as a matter of fact, and I know that all scripture is God-breathed and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness. We, as a parent, have a God-given responsibility to our kids. The writer of Deuteronomy says that we should impress God's commandments on the hearts of our children. Talk about them when you sit at home, when you walk along the road, when you lie down, and when you get up. This doesn't mean forcing them into a certain set of beliefs or rituals, but rather it means demonstrating in your own life a real faith. One that puts the focus on loving God and loving others. In my view, there's no greater purpose we can have in life than to reflect God's image to our children, that they might see Jesus in us. So the bottom line, our children are going to learn about the world around them and their role in it, whether from us or from this crazy world around us. They're going to take our lead or the world's lead. So be a champion for your kids, no matter whose kids they are. As a matter of fact, be a champion. Fight for them and then train them to be a champion. God bless.